Welcome back to the Call of Duty North American Championship 2015 presented by Xbox. Benson back in the booth. And our final, the cast-off contestant, we've got Dirk up here with me today. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. A little nervous, but it's been an okay day of casting. Yeah. I'm enjoying the event.
Yeah, how has the event gone as a whole for you?
I've really enjoyed it. Being able to meet the players, which usually I'm used to seeing in a little screen, everything like that. It's been really cool to see the actual environment and what goes down behind the scenes and all that stuff. So I've been really enjoying it.
And during the casting too, I know you've been killing it on Bravo. My timeline's full. Well, Dirk, love.
It's been fun on Bravo. We had a lot more, not 3-0s there.
Yeah,
it's
what
been
is
a lot
with
more intense
that,
matches.
By the way, you guys getting the good games, it seems, over there. Some 3-1s, some 3-2s. We're out here 3-0 Central.
Yeah.
I know Rambo's kind of a little bit salty about that stuff. Of course, up next, FaZe Black versus TR. Let's actually take a look at that FaZe Black squad. I've been really impressed with what I've seen from these guys, especially at the first event, MLG Columbus 2011. His role, the X factor of this team, if he goes off, you can expect big things from this FaZe Black squad. A 27.48 average Slayer rating as well. Honestly, look out for him in this series. I think he's going to be a key part.
Yeah, next player is going to be Proofy, a player who needs no introduction. First tournament, MLG Nationals 2009, one of the veterans in this community. Really, uplinks per game, 1.25, that is something that we're going to look out for.
Yeah, definitely. Of course, he's going to go on a bit of a cruise tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So today, the last day you'll really see FaZe Black advance through the tournament. Study, the next player on this FaZe Black squad. Absolutely phenomenal plays from him all throughout this tournament so far. Average 26.98 is a slaying category. Respawn KD of 0.97 as well. But when he gets hype, there's no one like him.
The Mr. Doug Martin, sensor. MLG Dallas first tournament. And look for him, the uplinks per game, maybe the OBJ player of this squad. Two uplinks per game, 22 slayer rating, 8% first blood rating.
Yep, definitely going to be the player to look out for on the FaZe Black squad in terms of who's going to be on the hill, who's going to be trying to pull the flag, etc., etc. Of course, they're going to be playing up against Team Revenge. And TR has been a team who kind of hit and miss. Failed to qualify for the Season 2 of the MLG Pro League, of course. Went last map against Optic Nation and just couldn't squeeze it out. But coming here, they kind of had a lot to prove, I feel.
Yeah.
And they've done that. I mean, advancing further than I think a lot of people had in the bracket. Now, though, going up against FaZe Black, how do you feel about their chances?
I mean, really strong. I had the privilege to cast them against Fear, which they 3-0'd. Then the next game, Denial. I think nobody really saw that coming with 3-0. I mean, I expected probably Denial to win that entire series, but I didn't expect the TR squad to take every map like that. I expected it to be a little closer.
Why do you think it was a 3-0 between Denial? Because I had Denial still, you know, hot favorite really coming into this event, but TR just dominated.
Yeah, it was just when I was in the crowd, I believe I was talking to Tasman. We're just kind of looking at the players, they all looked really tired. That's something you could tell just by the facial expressions and all, obviously all the flight delays and everything this weekend. But I believe it's maybe something along those, I believe they just had a meltdown compared to the team that we saw at the season playoffs.
Maybe. Of course, they're still fighting to guarantee qualification. Mm-hmm. You should just win that winner's bracket round, two games, and been through all of those now. So advancing further through the bracket, that's for sure. But TR versus FaZe Black. I'm going to ask you, prediction, and you can't say 3-0. Because I think, I'm going to say it again, Ray, this is for you. This is a game which has potential to not be 3-0.
Honestly, I'm going to go with the underdogs here, Team Revenge.
Really?
I feel like they're the underdogs. I feel like they're going to take this one 3-2. I'm going
3-2.
Last
you're going last. I'm going to write this down to you, saying 3-2.
It's time to break the curse. That's what it's
I agree.
For.
Break the curse. You're going to be the one that does it, I have a feeling. So in terms of 3-2 overall, who's going to win what in your mind?
Let's see. So we have Harpoon Bio left to start it off.
Yes, sir.
I feel like that is probably going to go in favor of this FaZe Black squad. I mean, both of these teams, obviously, they've been off to such a good start in this tournament, 3-0-ing their way to where they are right now.
Yep.
But, I mean, just the slaying power of this squad. I mean, you have the likes of Apathy, who had an excellent career in Ghost as well, and as well as Sensor, both those players actually teaming for the regionals and winning that one, too. So, I mean, that's I'm just going to give the hard points to FaZe Black, then S&D Solar. We saw what this Team Revenge squad was capable in that Search and Destroy against Denial, so I'm going to give that to them.
Makes sense. Moving on, the CTF, I believe it's Retreat. Who do you think stands struggling between the two there?
Struggling, you said?
No, who do you think stands out?
Oh, I'm going to go with Team Revenge there. Naga
Team Revenge again?
Naga Finn.
Yeah. He's pretty good at CTF.
I was writing down notes, and then I just sat there, and I was like, the only thing I need to write down is Naga Finn. I mean, he absolutely went off that entire series as well, so he's really like my standout player in that.
And then, of course, game five would be Ascension and Destroy Terrace, and you have TR picking it up in five maps. Interesting. I believe we actually have Mr. Christopher Puckett down on the analyst desk. Let's have a look at your thoughts on this next series.
All right, thank you, Ben. Here with Mr. Courage.
Yeah.
How you been? Good, man, good. Been a blast casting with a lot of the guys from the cast-off competition this weekend, showing a lot of skill from all of them. Excited to see Dirk now on the main stage, but another great match coming up here on Alpha.
Yeah, I think everyone should take note of this Team Revenge squad.
Oh,
they
yeah.
3-0 denial earlier today, part of the 3-0 club, and that was a shocker for everyone coming in, especially everyone who didn't watch these guys. They won the UMG Semi-Pro League, looking very strong in the qualifiers leading up to the last matches going into Season 2. They fell just short to Optic Gaming, but they even took Optic Nation. They took them to game number 5. Facento saying, I don't have to do anything on this team. It's all Aqua, Remy, and Nagafen. I'm really liking this squad. You have Remy, who is purely your objective player. Aqua, obviously your Slayer. And then Nagafen, he's just been able to pull off those ridiculous moments that gets the rest of the team fired up.
Oh, 100%. You know, they're coming into this tournament with nothing to lose. People aren't taking them as a favorite in any way. So they're going into these matchups, probably some of their strategies not too well known, as a lot of these big-name teams do scrim against each other left and right, while these guys have just been grinding the game, playing tournaments every day, day in and day out. They came this weekend to prove that they are one of the best teams here, and that's going to do it for this matchup, FaZe Black versus TR. Ben, back up to the booth to you.
Thanks, Jack. BioLab Hardpoint, about to get underway. Duck, who'd you want to spectate first in this one?
We have to show some love to Nagafen.
Nagafen? You're a Nagafen fan, huh?
I am. He impressed me.
Okay.
He really did. So that's who I want to start this game off with right here. And obviously, Hardpoint BioLab, this is what you really want to go for. That first hill, if you can get it good enough, it's going to give you about 30 to 35 seconds on that. Second hill, not so much, but that third hill, that's going to be one of the big hills of this map.
Yeah, one of those money hills for sure. As FaZe Black actually with the favorable spawn to kick things off here on BioLab Hardpoint. We'll see if Nagafen and the boys at TR can do anything about that. Looks like it's just going to be a real quick hit ice as quickly as you possibly can. Two players already down, but Remy and Facento get early control of the hill. Nice plays coming from them.
They're doing an excellent job staying on board with Remy right now. Going to be inside the hill with the ASM1. Able to pick up another kill there on a 4-streak to start off this one. So 4-0. We're not even past the first minute of this game yet. Still continuing his tear inside of the hardpoint. Excellent job by them so far. Facento is going to go down. Just like that, FaZe Black has control.
Nagafen trying to break that hill, unable to do so. Meanwhile, Aqua's going to fall. Two players from FaZe on the hardpoint. Now just Sensor. 25 seconds left before the hard point rotates over towards Eskies, and FaZe should be able to get some control. I think they were a little bit caught off guard, though, by that very quick TR play at the start.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Sensor inside the hardpoint, we brought up his OBJ player, but he's not going to be running any trophy system. That is something I just noticed, and I'm kind of surprised by that, but he does have the flak jacket on, so it kind of makes up for it.
Yep, going to be stacking those perks. Study on rotation has got Apathy there in support. Study a 6-1 start, by the way, a 5-streak overall. Going to stay on board with him. See if he can try and pick up some more kills on this hardpoint as FaZe actually starting to build themselves a bit of a lead. 40 to 14 currently, with plenty of time left on the second hardpoint.
Very, very nice job by Remy there, being able to take out the player that was in the back snow, kind of having that whole thing on lock. And that is kind of what started this little collapse here by FaZe Black. And just like that, they have controlled this hill. Remy and Facento, again, going to be inside. Facento off to a 1-6 start so far.
Yeah, a little bit rough from him. He's definitely going to need to pick things up as he gets himself another kill, but instantly falls. Remy, though, locking down this hill, 8-4 start from him. Now, of course, you mentioned that third hardpoint being so, so important, that kind of money hill, if you will. What time, roughly, do you think players should start rotating towards that?
Maybe around that, probably like around 15, 20 seconds around that mark, I would say. And that blue hill is one of those more closely contested ones. There's not going to be a whole lot of places that you can really just jump in. So if you position a player up on those boxes, kind of by where the player is up there right now, I believe that was actually going to be Study. Where he is, that head glitch is so nasty, it's going to be so hard to take him off of that.
Oh, Remy getting caught by the explosion. Looking at that score, 54 to 34. And you saw FaZe with a little bit of an earlier rotation there. And they should actually be able to lock this down.
Yeah, they definitely should. Sensor, going to be the player inside of the hardpoint right now, just making sure not to contest any silly gunfights, just getting on top of these boxes, like I said to do. Now, the spot where Sensor's at, if he goes to that right side door, kind of away from where Sensor is, there's a nice little spot there where you're easy positioning. You're going to be able to, that's the best spot to take out that player on that head glitch. I'm not sure if many people know about it, but that's definitely the place to go to.
Currently, TR struggling. You look at that kill column. Facento, 5 kills. Aqua, 5 kills. Nagafen, 5 kills as well. Definitely going to need to up the slaying pace. Going to have any chance here of taking this to FaZe Black. As you see, they do have a little bit of a dominating lead. 94 to 34 and growing as well, though.
Like we said, if you get a good setup on this, you're going to be able to control it for a majority of the time, and that is exactly what FaZe Black did. Going to break the 100-point mark with this hill. Now we're going to be going over to this green flat hill. Don't look for a team to really control this one all that much. More of a 50-50, really scrappy hill out in the open.
So Sento going to drop down, and Apathy in front of him wasn't able to pick it up, but shuts down Study. So he's trying to heat up a little bit, Dirk, but 6-13 again. The struggle is real for TR right now.
And Nagafin as well, 5-14 for the squad. Team Revenge not off to such a hot start. FaZe Black, otherwise, all the players doing such an excellent job. Sensor just doing what he needs to do. He's just been showing up. Obviously, he's supposed to just be chilling in the hard point. That's exactly what he's been doing.
Yeah, we talk about Apathy being that X Factor. Right now, 18-9, doing everything he possibly can to give FaZe as big a lead as possible. Sensor, meanwhile, just doing that OBJ roll, just kind of chilling on the hard point. There's one, there's two, looking for the third. Manages to just pick up the assist on that one. But yeah, he's holding his own on the hard point as well. 16-8, double positive for Sensor.
And as we rotate this next hill, going to be mid bio. Also one of those little money hills. Going to be very big, but if you're able to hold this one down and get all those main points where you can enter, you're going to be able to hold it down for a majority of the time. And this is where we really need to see some life out of Team Revenge. This is a hill where they can really start to build some momentum going to the next one.
Well, Nagafen just going to try and lock down this purple side. Purple's so important going into that final hill on rotation. You want to be locking it down. Try and control those spawns. Aqua's going to try and break in that. Looking for some kills. One player is going to be there. His teammate helps him out. That was Remy killing Apathy. Remy still alive on the hard point. He's going to fall. Nagafen with a quick challenge. He's going to be flooded by players, though. Trying to stay alive. Not going to happen. And FaZe Black break the hard point.
FaZe Black not scared to flood as many players in there as possible. I even saw three players in there at one point just to get control of that hill. But such an excellent job from this FaZe Black squad. 136-55, really putting Team Revenge into the ground.
Remy just chilling. 20 seconds left, of course, on this hard point. So plenty of time. And those points are going to be so crucial if TR are going to have a chance of coming back into this hard point game. That's for sure. 14 seconds left before the hard point is going to rotate. Of course, we're going to go into our second cycle of hard point rotations.
We highlighted Nagafin, and right now 11-21. Not really what you want to see. Maybe if it was an OBJ player and had some captures to kind of equal out with it, it would make a lot of sense. But he really needs to step it up if this team wants a chance of coming back.
Aqua going to be on the hardpoint early for Team Revenge. 136-82. Nagafin's going to be in support, but Aqua's already very, very weak. He needs to stay alive. Of course, has got Trophy System on his class. You see him just actually turn that on, waiting for a challenge, but. Yeah, FaZe Black spawning out. Good control by TR. This could be the comeback deck.
Spawning all the way out by that corner boom. That is not the spawn that you want. Just look how much time they're getting off this just because the players have to make that route all the way across the map. So excellent job by TR. And just like that, they're pulling themselves back into this game.
Three players on the hill. Is that something you would agree with or no?
I mean, sometimes I actually have seen that. Get three players on the hill, just kind of guarantee the control. Kind of have them in the corners, kind of looking at the entrances as well. Just able to lock that down. So it's kind of a weird strategy to see. But it's pretty common with some teams. And Sensor with a three-piece on the canister bombs.
That's going to extend his streak to five. FaZe break the hill once again. 7 seconds left before the hardpoint's going to rotate. And FaZe looking good. But TR definitely came back on that first hill. You see that score has drastically reduced to 151 to 117. And TR managed to rotate a little early there. But unfortunately, Aqua is going to be the last man for TR. Needs to win the gunfight. Wins the first, falls to the second, though. And FaZe gets some control.
They really played that hill so well, that little ring hill. By just being able to control those spawns, making FaZe Black spawn all the way out in that corner building by the snow, that is exactly what you want from that hill. Now let's see if they can carry over to the second hill. Like you said, a score 159 to 121. Aqua is going to be inside of the hardpoint right now. 6 captures to his name, 21-19. Currently on a 2-kill streak, doing some work.
I'll make that 3. Looking for more. He's actually going to be surrounded by players. Can he get the dropkick? He goes for it, but luckily has a teammate in support. But Aqua heating up towards the end of this hardpoint game. He's a little bit slow to start, but now 24-20. Remy just trying to help his teammates, but this is again all about the rotation. 12 seconds left. Who has rotated? Guess who? TR and it's Aqua. If TR lock this down, they are going to take the lead.
Yeah, definitely. This, like we said, such a big hill, and Aqua is in really the power position for this hill right now. He is going to be running that trophy system, so that's going to be good, but he's not going to put it on. But just like that, we see FaZe Black all flooding into the hill, and they are able to break that. Team Revenge played it really good early on the rotation.
Oh my goodness, Remy.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, Remy! Oh, he just single-handedly broke that hardpoint. That was absolutely phenomenal play. Keeps TR's hopes alive there, because if FaZe locked down this blue hill, Dirk, that's pretty much game over.
Yeah, I mean, Team Revenge first on those rotations. FaZe Black able to break it. Then Remy single-handedly going there, taking out the FaZe Black team and being able to take control of that hill. Aqua and Facento, we've seen them as kind of the duo in this, really sitting in the hills together, working together.
God, Remy.
Still on the tear. 7 kill streak for Remy. 8 captures to his name. He is having the game of a lifetime.
This is exactly what he needed to turn up. And guess what, Dirk? TR have taken control of the game. They now lead 177 to 168. FaZe desperately trying to push, but TR locking it down. Aqua with another another big kill. This is building up their lead as he just turns and burns on Apathy. I don't know what just happened at the end of this game, but TR just woke up.
Yeah, literally. Remy, we saw him going on a huge streak. Now Aqua's starting a streak of his own. 5 kill streak for him. And I don't know if he's going to be taken out yet. Was running across the snow. He's going to get contested. But Remy going to be the first player in this hardpoint. But Sensor going to be stuck in that green plat. About to drop the 40 bomb for the squad. But they are down. Trying to get some good time on this to bring this one back.
Sensor, the objective player, dropping the kills this game. He's going to need some help towards the end of this game, though. Teammates definitely need to step up to try and stamp down TR. Now a tied game going into the last minute and a half. Sensor, 1 kill away from the 40 bomb, but TR are going to be pushing him. He needs some help from his teammates. Player actually behind him, one in front of him. Sensor drops 40 so far. Time is ticking in. FaZe picking up a lot of time on this green plat.
And something I've been noticing Sensor's been doing, he's really just been using that exo jump to his ability, just jumping up and down. I know how frustrating it could be for players, really having to keep up with that all the time and trying to aim that down. But Sensor really doing everything he needs to, getting inside that hardpoint, also getting a lot of kills. To hit drop the 40 bomb now, 201 to 195 as we approach that 1 minute mark.
Oh, and TR holding down this last hill. That's big scrap time. That's going to give them a very fragile lead going into the final hardpoint. This one of the closest hardpoint biolabs we've seen here at the US Championship. Apathy, he's going to fall on the hardpoint. Now it's going to be contested. Remy and Sensor both on the hardpoint. Remy, can he win the gunfight? Yes, he can. But more players floating the hill. This time it's going to be Proofy from FaZe. TR get control and they can start to build themselves a lead.
Yeah, definitely. This is going to be coming down right to the wire. 204 to 203. Hill has been contested for around 15 seconds now. Let's see what's going to be able to happen. Remy, Aqua for Sensor on the hardpoint. Proofy doing his best to just be a nuisance inside. Is going to get taken out. Now TR
Remy
does have control. They're literally just going back and forth with this.
Oh, the dude is double jumping, trying to waste as much time as possible. Last 22 seconds, it's now going to be a tied game. Surely, Proofy and Study on the hardpoint. 206 to 205. FaZe take the lead. Study just goes big on the hardpoint. They're locking it down. 13 seconds left, and FaZe are going to take it. Surely, 10 seconds contested. They've done it. Nice plays from FaZe.
Yeah, definitely. Right there, Study threw in that nade, took out his own teammate, took out a player, then got a kill with the gun, the ASM-1 as well. Nice two piece by him, able to clear that hard point off. 218 to 205. And that was...
an insane hit. One of the closest I've seen on a hard point biolab. Sensor, 45-27. Talk about stepping up. You know, he gets a lot of bashing, I think it's fair to say, from the community sometimes, you know. Well, Dirk Sensor Martin hasn't got any thumbs. Proof gear right there, he definitely does.
Yeah, I mean, great game from him all around. Really close. I don't think FaZe Black wanted to be that close, so that's obvious.
Oh,
you never want games
not
to be close, but for us as casters and spectators as well, we always love seeing those close games.
Got to give Aqua some love as well. 38 and 28, dropping a 1.36 KD there, but overall Sensor, as I said, 1.67. When your OBJ player is getting that many kills, you know, it's very hard to lose a game like that, I feel, if you're FaZe, but TR making it close. They kind of a little bit sleep during the first half of that game, but brought it back in that second side, of course. Going over to a Search and Destroy on Solar. I think you said TR. Did you say TR was going to win the hardpoint? So it was close. Going into the S&D.
Well, no, I said
FaZe Black was going to win the hardpoint.
Yeah.
All right, so going into the S&D, you said TR was going to win it?
Mm-hmm.
Still confident about that?
I always have faith in the TR boys.
Always got faith. Always got faith. Well, for now, guys, quick commercial break. And when we return, we'll be jumping into that Search and Destroy.